A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 17th August, on the front page you have end of special status and internal matter, says India. So this reiterating that issues around Article 370 were an internal matter, India has played down the significance of UN Security Council's closed consultation meeting on Jammu and Kashmir. So India's stand is that it is an internal matter of the state. And this is Supreme Court counsels patience over Jammu and Kashmir. So it says give a little time for the situation to ease. So petitioners have filed before the Supreme Court, the case against government action of abrogating Article 370 of the Constitution in the state, on which Chief Justice of India Ranjan Gogoi said that he had read the newspapers and that landlines would be restored in the valley by evening is what he has been assured of. So he has read in the newspapers of such assurances. Then this is Chhattisgarh CM to double quota for OBCs. So we have seen this earlier in news too, how Chhattisgarh government has increased quota for OBCs significantly. So it is 27% for OBCs presently. Earlier it was around 14%. 13% as such. No first use nuclear doctrine is not rigid, says Rajnath Singh. So Union Minister Rajnath Singh has, Defense Minister Rajnath Singh has said that no first use nuclear doctrine which India has is not rigid. Means he is indicating that we may abrogate that too. Like we may go against that and we may be the first to use nuclear weapons too in case of a situation so arising. Then on regional pages we have coverage on flooding across the country in various states. In central and southern India as such. And on page 9 you have ISRO arm begins search for PSLV makers. So this is NSIL, New Space India Limited, which is a new public sector space business company which has been launched, which has launched a formal search for industry consortia which can regularly manufacture and deliver entire PSLV vehicles, Polar Satellite Launch Vehicle vehicles as such for its parent, that is Indian Space Research Organization. So NSIL invites expression of interest from experienced companies to produce launchers. And this is India gets its first national essential diagnostics list. So current system can manage only a few notified devices. So now India has got its first national essential diagnostics list finalized by Indian Council of Medical Research, which aims to bridge the current regulatory systems gap that do not cover all the medical devices and in vitro diagnostic devices. So this notification will change this scenario where current system can manage only a few notified devices. So India has become the first country to compile such a list that would provide guidance to the government for deciding the kind of diagnostic tests that different healthcare facilities in villages and remote areas require. So it will provide these facilities in the villages. World Health Organization has also released the first edition of its essential diagnostics list in May 2018. But even though this World Health Organization's essential diagnostics list acts as a reference point for development of national EDL, India's diagnostic list has been customized and prepared as per landscape for India's healthcare priorities. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Justice for the Mob. So this is regarding the Pehlu Khan case in which all accused have been acquitted by a Sessions Court as such in Rajasthan. So this says this acquittal imperils the country's image. So it's a cause of concern. And this is making CSR work, that is corporate social responsibility. So this editorial says that non-compliance by corporates should be decriminalized and made a civil offense. It cannot be a criminal offense if companies do not have corporate social responsibility undertaken. Then the lead article is a considered step that opens up new vistas. So this is regarding Kashmir's special status being abrogated. So the Vice President of India, M. Venkaiah Naidu, gives his viewpoint on this issue. And this is giving shape to an elusive strategic concept. So this is the post of Chief of Defence Staff which has been announced in the Independence Day speech. So this is an article on that. It says this will enable more efficiency in defence planning and help civil-military relations. Then on Saturdays on the op-ed page, you have ground zero coverage on which one particular issue is covered. So this issue is on rice cultivation in Punjab, which thrived in the past due to easy availability of water resources and free supply of electricity to farmers, is now under considerable strain. So how overexploitation has made groundwater not only scarce but also increasingly alkaline is a cause of concern here. Then on international page, you have White House approved sale of F-16 fighter jets to Taiwan. So US President Donald Trump has approved $8 billion sale of F-16 fighter jets to Taiwan against China's wishes. Then below you have Greenland tells Trump it's not for sale. So US President Donald Trump discussed the idea of buying the Danish region with his advisors. So Greenland belongs to Denmark, but this has been dismissed. As you know, it that Greenland is up for sale. And on the business page here, you have recession fears highest since 2011. So this is what a survey says: corporates are over leveraged and must improve their balance sheets. So concerns are high. So that is it. These are the important headlines. There is no coverage on the last page. There's sports coverage on the last page. Thank you.